500.
All right, we're going to go ahead and set up another flight up to the Salmon River area in Idaho. As you can see, I've got a lot of add-ons up in this area, so I'm doing it from the world map so that you can see the ones I've grabbed. So instead of from the McCall map, from the McCall base, we're going to go ahead and start from parking spot here at Kressel. And then we will set our arrival for Allison Ranch. And what we'll do is we will come up past Wiley. We will land at Yellow Jacket, and then we'll come over the hill instead of going down the river or over to Shep Ranch via the canyon. We'll go ahead and land at Warren and drop some stuff off, and then head up to Shep and come through this ravine right here. We'll then come up to Dixie, and then we will come back over the ridge to the Salmon River and wrap up at Allison. We can add another waypoint here. Sure, we'll just add this one as well. So roughly this is going to be our flight path. Sometimes the in VR the map gets stuck. So, all right. So that's kind of what we'll end up doing. Let's go ahead and get our weights in balance. So we'll remove the co-pilot. We'll give a passenger to drop off. It'll be the scalded hands guy. We'll set 50 on the left, 50 on the right, and the third section there, and in the fourth section we'll do 50, and we'll do 100 just to balance it out for me. Pilot, all right, and we're about even there, so, and that looks like that'll work. We're gonna be parked. All right, there we go. Just making sure everything's working here. Okay, let's go ahead and get our car on here, get our aux bus on. Let's go ahead and turn off our breaker down here to turn off this guy. Hit the other aux bus, get our AC going here. I've got a passenger and some cargo. We're at Kressel here. Let's get our beacon and nav on.
Pause system test, okay.
Gonna start the engine, we'll get the oxygen monitor on. We're waiting for our gyros to initialize here. Let's get our CDI configured. Get our nav mode on. So capture GPS once we get out there. Okay, we're ready to... Actually, let's make sure we got our fuel cuffs on here. And we're good to go ahead and get an engine start here. Clear prop. We're going to watch the NG pressure here and make sure that we idle around 20%. Or stabilize, I should say. So stabilizing and bring it up. And we're going to watch the inner turbine temperature and make sure that we stay below 600. Avoid a hot start here. And we should be fine. So bring the prop up. We'll bring our starter down off and turn off the pump, flip on the alternator and generator, go ahead and lock in here. Let's get our, announce our taxi.
24 kilo traffic BAE 1001 is taxiing to runway 17.
Get our taxi light on there. We'll stay at low idle, just a taxi. And we'll come down here and set ourselves up. So I think we're probably going to go with just a hair less pitch trim than usual. We can go to stage one of flaps. We'll go ahead and turn on our pitot heat. And we can flip the landing lights and the strobe on as we are on the runway. A nice little helicopter pad here. Come down to the very end here. Rotate around here.
24 kilo traffic BAE 1001 taking off runway 35 north departure.
All the way up. Let's go ahead and turn off our AC here. We have generator alternators configured, all of our lights are configured, pitots are on, we are locked in, fuel's configured, everything's all good, and passengers are all good to go. Okay, I'm gonna hold the brake down, build some pressure, and release. Airspeed's alive. On 50, 60, and rotate. Just up. Go ahead. Let go of that trim and flaps. Trims back to neutral. Flaps are at zero, and we are headed to Yellow Jacket Ranch. We can go ahead and back off on the prop condition a bit.
500.
Yep. And we are good to go. So I'll build some altitude here and probably 10 minutes be at Yellow Jacket, maybe less, 5 minutes. Less of a hike from McCall, where we used to do about 10 minutes coming in. 10, 15 minutes. Get some flashing red there on our NG, so pull back. Make sure we keep our pressure green.
500.
Let's go ahead and thin the mixture just a little bit more. Dial down my butt kicker a bit. Back into the red on the NGs again. Turbulence here. So we usually come from McCall, or I should say I usually come from McCall. That's some unfortunate texture work needs to be done there. I do have the textures on low, or not low, sorry, medium, to see if I can, they don't bother me too much, and I want to see if I can get a bit better performance for my recordings. We'll see how that goes. So We're looking at that second ridge back there. We are overspeeding. I think I see our dip there. If you look at it like a camel's back, we're to the right of the right hump there. So we're at 140 knots. Let's go ahead and introduce our first stage of flaps. Start slowing ourselves down. Gosh, a lot of turbulence. Probably the most I've had on an approach here. Get that second stage of flaps in there so we can try to work out all our relationships before we get to that ridge. So when we get to that ridge, we want to be about 90 knots, 85 to 90 on our final little approach as we hit the threshold there. I'll hold off on that last stage of flaps, unless I can see if I can just reduce my speed a bit here, because we are going to have to dip as soon as we cross. Looking pretty good. Not hating this. Got a little bit of a wind to the left there, it looks, feels like, anyway. And down here.
500.
Reversers. Come up the hill. Alright, that was not bad. I'm gonna go ahead and turn around here. Crosswind there. Okay. Let's go ahead. We're going to dump our guest here. So enjoy, sir. We will alleviate ourselves of your load, and we will also get rid of a bit of your luggage. There we go. So now, got some luggage, and we drop this stuff off. All right, well, still got our taxi landing on from our takeoff there. That's okay. We're going to go with one stage of flaps, just a little bit of trim, pitch trim. And what we're going to do is, the trick here is not to try to go over this. You want to turn to the right here. We will just get off the runway before the bushes here, and we will keep our nose down and just keep our airspeed alive. Get a positive rate of climb and head out this way. So, all right. Just think about that wind. I think we're gonna be okay. All right. Let's go get our condition and prop all the way. We're gonna go ahead and hit full engine here. And release. Airspeed's alive. up, and we're pulling back. We're off. We're just gonna float to the right here. Do not want to climb. Just avoid stall.
500.
We're all good. There we go. Let's go ahead and pull back on our prop condition a bit. We're going to head up over the ridge up there. Go ahead, back off the flaps and pull back on our trim. Still got our 3 degrees rudder trim in there, which that did not feel too bad. Probably could have used a bit more with that guy over there. So when he left, I think it was enough. It was perfect, so. Alright. Don't actually remember the name of this next strip that we're landing at. I believe it's in a little ravine. So we'll follow this up. And then we'll proceed to Shep. So in the prior video, we went that way, we went out to the Salmon River. Oh yeah, we had a little mountain road that we're taking up here. It must be quite a sight. Alright, let's go ahead and turn off our AC. It's feeling pretty good. We can turn off our landing lights and our taxi. Back off on that NG pressure. It's really plaguing me today. Alright, and I believe our strip is down in this valley here. You know, 500. We're just gonna fly over this.
500.
I like the little road traveling through. That's great. So we'll take a look at this as we go over it.
500.
But we'll go down to Shep. Just to keep the flight moving along here. I don't think there's anything particularly interesting about this.
500.
Oh, they did a nice job. They got some buildings down there. Looks like some little campsites. Oh, that looks great. That's a nice little airstrip. Alright, so we'll head over here. What we're going to be looking to do is come down this ravine into Shep. So we're going to head over into this area over here. It's got textures on medium, clouds I think on high, I want to say. Looks good so far. this is it's gonna be interesting coming into ship. It's gonna be quite a drop there. Allison Ranch is over that way. The Salmon River is right down to the bottom of that. And we're headed over here to meet the other portion of it. So. Purposely keeping us
500.
Low and slow here. Because we're going to be coming down into this.
Five hundred.
I think we want to stay to the left over here. Made this mistake before. So I think we'll get a shot of Shep Ranch down there. See if we can. You know what? Let's go ahead. We're gonna go ahead and do a deep loop here. Just try to lose some altitude here and burn some speed. Some speed here.
500.
Right. So now we will head, I think, to Dixie. Is that the one we're going to? come down here to the end. That was not too bad, actually. Old caravan there, or is that a... Oh, that was a, Kodiak? Alright, I'll come down here and kind of turn around a bit. Alright. Hopefully we can get airborne before that bump. We will pull the flaps back. This is gonna be interesting. Let me think. You know what? I think I'm gonna try. Looks like it's stage of flaps. You know what? I'm gonna do one. Alright. Let's go ahead and flip on our landing. Alright, let's do this. So, full brake. Bumping. Airspeed's alive. Keep the nose down. Keep the nose down. And we're out. Back off on the prop and lean it a bit and just slowly build some altitude here. All right. That's not a bad approach in the ship. Build some altitude here. Then we'll take it in for landing there. Just trying to figure out. Don't think we'll have to kind of exit at the end up here. I don't think I'd want to try to climb up before that. So we'll just continue here. What's going to happen is we're going to have to swing out a bit to come in for our landing. And then we can jump the ridge there and head over to Allison Ranch. So, she might be able to get over the ridge here not too long as we build. So, thermals are carrying us up for sure. Feel the lift. Yeah. So let's get up here.
500.
Wow, what a view, man. Here's our little airstrip. So we will come out here why don't we do... We'll do a landing from the north, come in, and then we'll exit out and head out that way, so... Make our crosswind turn here. We'll head out a little bit, and we'll come in for our landing. And we'll just do a touch and go on that strip down there. Might have to get a view of Allison over here. Allison Ranch would be right behind that area over there. Head over the ridge and head up to the Salmon Valley area. Let's build some speed up here. We'll come over here. We're going to be re-entering the Salmon River Valley. Come over the ridge here. I'll just kind of coast down here. Look at all those logs that have fallen. It's funny. Strip there. Too far here. We got a couple more turns here. Coming to Allison, and there's a nice little lodge. Relax out. Another little ranch, little airport, little airstrip. Okay, so we can see the little knot, little protrusion out there, that hump the river is. So we need to maintain enough airspeed. Let's say low to mid 90s as we make our turn. Little to the left here, just so that we can then angle ourselves along the side of this ravine here, this hillside.
500.
We're going to go to stage 2 flaps, and there you can see our green airstrip showing up there. Okay, we're at 95, nice stable 95. Right into the trees.
Oh,
that's good. Good ending to the flight. A little hot coming in there. All right, that's okay. I'm happy with that.